This video is about how to modify Excel files with Python. For example, I have here a financial report XLSX file with the following data. And the total revenue cells contain the sum formula. For the sake of the video, I want to modify the values of these cells and save the report to a new file, so that formulas of the total revenue cells will be saved. I mean that I want to keep formulas in the cells. So first of all, I have to install Openpyxl library to read Microsoft Excel files. Pip install Openpyxl. And in my Python script, first of all, I have to import the load workbook method function. And to read an Excel file, I have to call the load workbook function and pass into it the path to the file I want to open. So let's create a variable and let's call the load workbook function. And as the financial report file is in the same directory as my Python script, I can pass into the load workbook function just the name of the file. The next step. I need to get the working spreadsheet. My file contains two sheets. Sheet 1, sheet 2. And we can get its sheets by calling this sheet names property. And if we run the script, we'll get a list with the names of our sheets. And to get the particular sheet, we can use square brackets like with the dictionaries, for example. Sheet 1. This expression will return an instance of the worksheet class that we can use. Or we can use here the active property that will return the active sheet. Let's save it to a variable. The sheet variable is an instance of the worksheet class that is an iterable object, and it means that we can iterate through it in loops. Let's start the for loop for row in sheet. So let's print the row variable. And we can see that the sheet is a sequence of tuples. And each tuple represents a row of the spreadsheet. And also we can see that each tuple contains cells. In its turn, each row variable, a tuple, is also an iterable object. Let's iterate through them as well. I need the nested for loop for cell in row, print cell. If we run the script, we'll get all cells of the spreadsheet. But each cell is an instance of the cell class, as we can see. And to get the value of a cell, I have to use its value property. And at the bottom of the output, we can see the cells that contain formulas. Okay, also, I can specify a range of cells and rows accordingly that I want to get. For example, I wanted to modify the values of the cells from B5 to F5 inclusively. And so I can specify here the range of cells I want to get. I need the cells from B5 colon F5. And it looks like slicing in lists. So let's run the script, and we can see the values of these 5 cells. Let's assume that we have some data from a database, for example, or from another Excel file. it doesn't matter. For the sake of brevity, I want to create a new data list, new data, with 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 values. And now I want to match the values of the new data list with the values of the cells I've got in the for loop. I want to get an element of the new data list and assign it as the value to the according cell. I think that it's a good idea to use here the enumerate function. So the inner for loop will be the following. And gets the second variable index and the raw variable I am passing into the enumerate function. And the enumerate function gets an iterable object as an argument and returns a tuple with two elements. And in each iteration of the for loop, the cell variable gets the element of the raw list. And the index variable gets its index in the list. And the body of the inner for loop will be the following. I want to assign to the value attribute of the cell variable a new value. That'll be the element of the new data list with the index index. The value of the index variable I've got from the enumerate function. And that's it. To save the workbook to a file, I have to call the save method of the book variable and specify here a new path to the file or a new name. New report, for example, Excel SX. Let's run the script and we can see that the new report was created. Let's open it. And we can see here the new values of these cells and at the same time the sums are working well. If you like the video, please leave a like and subscribe for the channel. Thanks for watching.